Hi YouTube, BattleMasterPvP here, and I'm going to be making my third hunter guide video. Now, in my previous videos, which I'll link in the description, I went over a lot of stats and talents and just kind of stuff that has nothing to do with gameplay really, just enchants and shit like that. But today I'm going to go over you guys some like actual gameplay mechanics. Now, some of these are really simple, but I don't think that a lot of hunters are going to know these, so I'll demonstrate. My first thing here is going to be to spin when you disengage to go in the direction you want to go. So as long as you're in combat, you can just kind of do whatever, you know. Sometimes if you lag, it'll mess it up a little bit. Or if maybe your mouse messes up, like whatever it does, it decides to hit on a particle of dust or hair or some shit, and it'll mess it up sometimes. And it takes a little bit of practice to really disengage right where you want to go. So the second thing is going to be when you're in the arena, there's someone that has stealth, like a mage or another hunter. You kind of want to like spam Hunter's Mark at the start, because you can really mess them up if you do that. Another thing is going to be, like, when you see an incoming cast, like a CC or like a Frost Bomb or Chaos Bolt or something big, you want to like feign death the cast. It'll interrupt it. Don't just like feign death randomly unless you're at really low health. Now, the next thing is kind of a general PvP thing. It just has to do with Night Elves, because I happen to have a Night Elf Hunter, so, your Shadow Meld kind of works as a feign death. You can meld CCs, and you can meld and just stay melded if you're at low health, and it gives your healer some time, especially if you CC'd. Don't forget to fear Ferals. A lot of Ferals know to shift whenever you're gonna fear them, but if you feign death before you start casting the fear, then a lot of the times they won't notice it quick enough, especially in RBGs and like random battlegrounds and stuff like that. A lot of the times they'll just eat the fear because they don't see it coming at all. You can actually use camouflage as a defensive. It's not that great and it wastes 40 focus, but you know, when you're about to die, you do whatever you can to try to stay alive. Make sure that you're using Widowed Venom, and make sure you're using it, like you time it well. Don't just leave Widowed Venom up the whole time, because it's kind of pointless, but if you're trying to kill a healer, you want to make sure you have Widowed Venom on him, or if you know a healer is going to come out of a CC, you want a Widowed Venom, like, the kill target, in order to try to keep him low before the next CC can come out. Make sure that you're specking your pets for ferocity, because, especially if you're BM, people can just global your pet, and you really need this Heart of the Phoenix to keep your pet alive. Now, for explosive traps, a lot of the times I like to, like trap the target first, and because the explosive trap will knock people back in the opposite direction that you put it towards them. So if you put it on like the right side of somebody, it'll throw them left. So it takes some getting used to. I mean, it's really good because you kind of like have like a positionless knockback. And the last thing I want to talk about is assist macros for RBGs. You want to make sure that you have an assist macro for the Frost DK or whoever's calling the targets, so that way you don't have to like click around a lot. You can just make it a macro and instantly be on the target that they're calling. It helps a lot in threes too, if you put an assist for your other the other DPS on your team, because you don't have to like click it on Gladius or the frames or whatever. But yeah, that was my third video. I'm probably going to end up doing 4 or 5 of these, and I'll end up linking them all together, so that way anybody can find them all easily. My next video is probably going to go more in depth on a lot of the macros that I use, but thanks for watching my video. Have a great day, YouTube.